Hello everyone, I am Dr. Shweta. Welcome to activity 16. So we are on a journey of gratitude and doing this book magic, and those who have done each and every activity or missed some activity but done most of the activities, congratulations to them. If you have noticed, you must have gone into this process or you must have gained an attitude of gratitude toward everything. Some people have shared their experience with me that they are now looking to bounties and blessings what universe have given to them, or they have received from universe, to acknowledge and feel grateful about. Similarly, some people say that every morning I get up and I ask myself, what is there today to celebrate out of this day, or what blessings I have received so that I acknowledge them and celebrate them, or what happened today that I should feel grateful for and should celebrate. Similarly, look, we have skipped or transformed ourselves from getting up in the morning and saying that I have not got a good sleep or things like that, and getting in the bed with worries and anxieties of the whole day, or I have not done good enough, or these things are remaining, etc., etc. Carrying those things to the bed, we have turn ourselves into getting up with gratitude and sleeping with gratitude. And this, our attitude of feeling grateful, dribbles on our tomorrow, and we get into the vicious cycle of feeling more grateful and attracting more things to be feeling grateful about. Like, each and every day of ours has become a blessing for us. There is abundance everywhere. Abundance in rain, that is abundance of water, abundance of joy, abundance of aliveness. It is just you need to recognize it and acknowledge it. And what better word can be there to acknowledge abundance than gratitude? Psychologists say that there are two reasons you should be in the state of gratitude. That is, main emotion that we mess up with is anger and fear. Look, you cannot be angry and grateful simultaneously. Similarly, you cannot be grateful and fearful simultaneously. So they are exactly opposite, and they create exactly opposite hormones, so you cannot feel them both together. So by practicing this attitude of gratitude daily, actually you are skipping this both emotion, so you are not messing up with your life, and in fact you are creating a great life to feel worthy to live for. Gratefulness is an experience. I must say, if you divide this word, it's like great and fullness. It's an experience of gratefulness of the bowl of life. Like, you have a full bowl of life with all the good things you have in your life, and you are counting it day by day. You are putting 10 more blessings every day. So now it's like overflowing the bowl. And when you have this gratefulness of your life with good things, you will like, or you will have a power inside to share it with others, or give it to others, or contribute something to the society. And when you do all these things, three things of giving, sharing and contribution, actually it will make you fulfilled or satisfied internally. And what richness can be more than this for feeling of satisfaction and fulfillment? And when you feel satisfied and fulfilled, actually you will notice, you'll say thank you, so you are feeling grateful again. So it's a vicious cycle you are going into. Like, you are feeling satisfied, so you will feel grateful, and when you feel grateful, you will share, contribute, and again you will feel satisfied. So you are going into great circle, and congratulations to those who have followed all these things. You might be having so many experiences. Do share it with other group members so that they also get motivated to. Feeling grateful for the things you have is a foundation for attracting abundance in life. If you understand this single sentence, you know how powerful being gratitude or feeling gratefulness is. Similarly, if you still say that I don't have anything to be grateful about, then you are sounding absurd. Or psychologists say that some people are trapped in their story so much that they don't look around what is good happening in their life. So check out for yourself if you are trapped in in some stories or things like that and Google out things or find out similar people who are suffering from same kind of things, and then you'll notice that how people come out of these things and see what good is lies in their life. I've shared with you the story of Nick, who is crippled and still facing different situations and day-to-day activities like a task for him and doing them, and he is a motivational speaker. What great